I first came in 2011, and I brought a dozen of my students, and we came here as a little traveling group, and I wanted to share the pleasure with my students at the time. I'd been invited before, and as I mostly shot my movies in the summer, I was never able to follow the invitation. For years, I thought I can make it to Sarajevo this year, and then it never happened. So finally, on long-term planning, it worked out in 2011. And we had a week here and did workshops and all sorts of things, and I traveled a little bit and walked, and we showed Pina, and we had the best of times, and ever since I wanted to come back, and again it took me 10 years. It has its own feeling, Sarajevo. It brings its own aura, so to speak. And the aura is of openness and of multicultured kindness towards each other. I think that's what it stands for. And in a strange way, I've always hoped that my films would stand for that as well, for openness and kindness. So I love what Sarajevo brings to the films, not just what the films bring to Sarajevo and the festival, but also what the festival brings to the films. And I liked the audience last time. It was thrilling to show Pina. I'm happy that I'm showing several of my films this time, and I'm going to go with the audience. I just introduced Alice in the Cities, and I'm going to be there at the end again, and I introduced several of my films. And I like spending time with the audience, and Sarajevo has its very own feeling, and it's very kind, open, gentle atmosphere towards films. It is almost like, as a filmmaker, you can't always decide on your audience, and you meet hostile audiences also. And if you travel with your films, you see a different film everywhere where you go. You see it with the audience, and you see a different film in London or in America or in Asia. You see your own films with different eyes. So you can't paint your audience, so to speak. But if I had to determine which audience I really liked and which I'd always like to show my films to, it was from my Sarajevo experience. I think it's so utterly important because you see, not only here in the Balkan area, but all over the world, you see that there's a new kind of nationalism evolving everywhere. And they seem to take over, and they like to think of themselves as the voices of the people, which is a disaster because they are the voices from the past, and they are deadly voices. So, and especially here, this region has had a lot of that deadly conflict of clashing nationalist ideas. And there's nothing better to heal these wounds than storytelling and cinema and common experiences and cultural experiences. And if people remember how they lived together in Sarajevo for so long, I think they will certainly remember good times. And Sarajevo for the world is an example how cultures live together peacefully and in exchange. So a new generation of filmmakers has a big task here. They are the ideal counterweight against the onslaught of the old ideas of nationalism. And they're coming back in my country, just as in Germany, just as well as in France, or everywhere on the planet, these voices come back, and I think culture in general, but especially cinema, it has a privileged position to counteract that. We see an amazing onslaught on the idea of truth in our times. Who would have thought that? Who would have thought that we go back to medieval ideas? And who would have thought that these theories and these internet-born what's the English word for it, Verschwörungstheorie, these abstruse twisting of truth, which we see everywhere, and especially in our own Western culture, and everywhere else anyway. So truth has become an endangered species, really. And cinema has the ability to uncover truth. And storytelling, especially if you tell stories, there is a truth to a story. Last night, I watched Denis Stanovich's new comedy that he shot this year here in Sarajevo. And I liked it a lot because it was truly local. And I love all cinema that has a local touch. I love all cinema that is based in a region and that deals with their conflicts and taste and weather and thinking. And this film is like a crash course of what it means to be here. And it was a beautiful film for me. I arrived in the afternoon and then I saw that film and I was smack dab in the middle of Sarajevo again and its conflicts and its pleasure and its honesty and its humor. And I love the film because it shows how you can deal with conflict. It shows that communities can be open and can have forces from all sides still, even if they fight, but there's still a way to deal with it, and another way than war and conflict. There is a humanness about it. I loved coming back to Sarajevo with that film. So, and tonight I'm really looking forward to seeing Quo Vadis Aida. And I know all of Jasmila's films, and I'm really looking forward to seeing this one. Because they're entrenched in their own culture, in their own history, they're specific. And I love the language of films when they become specific, when they're not about just anywhere, which is nowhere, but if they're really talking about place and about people who live their lives there and who shows the reality of a place and also the truth of a place. Truth is always complicated, and it's nowhere on the planet, maybe in Palestine, it's more complex than truth than here in the Balkans. But it's beautiful to see it unravel and to see how you can deal with it, and that humor is such a great capacity of mankind to deal with conflict. And last night, I mean, I'm making movies for 50 years now, I realized, and as doing the film, I realized, damn, you did a lot of movies, Wim, but not one comedy, and it's about time, because it is such a beautiful, peaceful capacity that we have as filmmakers to solve conflicts. You know, Benigni's film, Isn't Life Wonderful? He did, for instance, also The Impossible. The Nazi atrocities in a comedy, you'd think impossible. But it was possible. And conflicts in movies can be solved in a way that you come out and you see the world with different eyes. And you see we have tools as humanity. We have tools and we have abilities. And we can do things and we can live peacefully with each other. And that's a great quality of cinema. And I very much hope in this young generation coming from the entire ex-Yugoslav area to really help us promote this idea.